The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. We beseech thee, Almighty God, mercifully to look upon thy people, that by the great goodness they may be governed and preserved evermore, both in body and soul, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray, Almighty and everlasting God, who hatest nothing that thou hast made, and dost forgive the sins of all those who are penitent, create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of thee, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, art one God, world without end.
Amen.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the 9th chapter of Hebrews, beginning at the 11th verse. Christ, being come and high priest of good things to come, by a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctifieth to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 8th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 46th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said, which of you convinceth me of sin? And if I say the truth, why do ye not believe me? He that is of God heareth God's words. Ye therefore hear them not, because ye are not of God. Then answered the Jews and said unto him, say we not well that thou art a Samaritan and hast a devil? Jesus answered, I have not a devil, but I honor my Father, and ye do dishonor me. And I see not mine own glory. There is one that seeketh and judgeth. Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. Then said the Jews unto him, now we know that thou hast a devil. Abraham is dead, and the prophets, and thou sayest, if a man keep my saying, he shall never taste of death. Art thou greater than our father Abraham, which is dead? And the prophets are dead. Whom makest thou thyself? Jesus answered, if I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honoreth me, of whom ye say that he is your God, yet ye have not known him. But I know him, and if I should say I know him not, I shall be a liar like unto you. But I know him, and keep his saying. Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it, and was glad. And then said the Jews unto him, Thou art yet not 50 years old, and hast thou seen Abraham? Jesus said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am. Then took they up stones to cast at him, but Jesus hid himself and went out of the temple. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. I think most of the announcements are in the bulletin, and the one that we published first and foremost is the Holy Week schedule. You'll see that we have daily masses throughout Holy Week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and even Friday with the Mass of the Pre-Sanctified and also the Good Friday Quiet Day, which will entail a variety of very important and intimate and personal things like litanies. And we're also going to have about an hour and a half or so when, if you are so moved after our self-examination throughout Lent, you will be afforded the opportunity of confession or auricular confession. If you are a visitor with us, we welcome you to St. Luke's Church. Do sign the guest book, and if you are confirmed by a bishop, Catholic, Anglican, or Orthodox, then you are welcome to receive the Most Holy Sacrament at this time and at this day. However, if you're not confirmed, you can still come up and I will give you a blessing during the midst of the Mass and the liturgy. And you can see what I'm talking about just by on the front page of the bulletin. You can see the stipulations and the various and sundry other things about St. Luke's Church. It's a very magnificent church. We are small, but boy, are we strong. We have people who the Holy Spirit resides in their heart, mind, and soul, and they are also residing in their actions too. Sermon hymn. It's a great hymn. Hymn number 438. Let's stand and sing it together.
Teach me thy will, and I rejoice.
Last week's gospel reading, the feeding of the 5,000, left Jesus' disciples on a spiritual high. And by the word disciples, I mean all of those who professed to follow Jesus, not just the 12 apostles. John tells us that immediately afterwards, the people exclaimed, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world." Concerned that the people would try to take him by force to make him their king, Jesus immediately withdrew to the wilderness. In other words, he hid himself. The very next day, however, Jesus began a series of public teachings that seriously eroded his newfound popularity. He said somewhat cryptically, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst." To the literal-minded disciples of Jesus, this made no sense. But then, Jesus made things even worse in their minds by making an even more outrageous claim. "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Whoever feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day." That was simply too much for many of Jesus' disciples, and in all fairness, we can at least sympathize with those who wondered how eternal life could only be obtained by eating the flesh and drinking the blood of a still-living itinerant Jewish rabbi. Not surprisingly, John tells us that many of Jesus' disciples responded, "This is a hard saying. Who can listen to it?" So they turned back and no longer walked with Jesus. Nevertheless, some of Jesus' relatives saw an opportunity. The Feast of Booths, or the Feast of Tabernacles, was approaching, and they urged Jesus to join them in Judea, specifically Jerusalem, where they could essentially show him off to the disciples there, telling them that his hour had not yet come, and clearly not wanting to make the type of public splash that his relatives desired, Jesus declined and sent them on their way. Secretly, though, Jesus later entered into Jerusalem on his own and began to teach in the temple midway through the eight-day feast. Some of the Jews were converted by his preaching. Others accused him of having a demon because he claimed, correctly as it turns out, that some were plotting to kill him. Again, John mentions that no one laid a hand on Jesus because his hour had not yet come. In a somewhat humorous interlude, John recounts how the Pharisees sent officers to arrest Jesus. But on the last day of the feast, the officers came back empty-handed. The incredulous Pharisees asked the officers, "Why did you not bring him?" And the officers answered, "No one ever spoke like this man." By the end of the feast, some thought that Jesus was the so-called prophet. Some thought he was the Christ or Messiah. Others thought he was mad or that he had a demon. Yet others thought that he was a blasphemer who should be put to death. During his time in the temple, Jesus had made many bold claims. "The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. No one can come unto me unless it is granted him by the Father. I know the Father, for I come from him and he sent me. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. If you knew me, you would know my Father also. And finally, you are of this world. I am not of this world. I told you that you would die in your sins, for unless you believe that I am he, you will die in your sins." Exasperated by these audacious statements, Jesus' listeners asked him point blank, "Who are you?" This question sets the stage for today's gospel lesson, the climax of this part of Jesus' ministry. After some additional back and forth between Jesus and his audience, Jesus proclaims precisely who he is. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am." In saying this, Jesus had uttered the ultimate blasphemy, claiming not only to be sent by God, but to be God himself. We know this by looking back at Exodus chapter 3. Moses, having fled Egypt after killing an Egyptian taskmaster, encounters the famous burning bush. There, God commands Moses to return to Egypt and lead the Israelites out of bondage. Moses had several objections to this calling, and his first one was natural. If I come to the people of Israel and say to them, "The God of your fathers has sent me to you," and they ask me, "What is his name?" what shall I say to them? God said to Moses, "I am who I am." And God said, "Say this to the people of Israel, 'I am has sent me to you.' This is my name forever, and thus I am to be remembered throughout all generations." It is no wonder then that when Jesus called himself the great I am, those whose eyes were blinded and who lacked understanding sought to stone him immediately. No arrest was needed, no time-consuming trial was required for such an outrageous claim. Yet John tells us, Jesus hid himself and went out of the temple. Not because he was afraid. After all, Jesus had just moments earlier predicted his own crucifixion. Rather, Jesus had hid himself that day because, as we are repeatedly told, his hour had not yet come. Jesus would return later to the temple with great fanfare, and that occasion is the triumphal entry which we will commemorate next Sunday. Meanwhile, today, the beginning of Passion Tide, we commemorate the hidden Jesus, symbolized by the veiling of all crosses and crucifixes in purple. This veiling reminds us that we too are often blind to Jesus because of our sins. We are reminded to intensify our own examination of conscience, asking the Holy Spirit to remove the veil from our spiritual eyes so that we may see Jesus more clearly and that we may perceive and confess those hidden sins which beset us. Sins we do not remember or have committed in ignorance. Sins also which we simply have not acknowledged and confessed. In this Passion Tide, let us daily pray David's heartfelt plea in Psalm 19. C.S. Lewis's favorite psalm, by the way. O cleanse thou me from my secret or hidden faults. Keep thy servant also from presumptuous sins, lest they get the dominion over me. So shall I be undefiled and innocent from the great offense. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice for the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and to make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, because that by our bodily fasting thou dost curb our sinfulness, dost raise our minds from things of earth, dost renew our strength, and reward us with manifold blessings through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we in all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils past, present, and to come, in the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
I receive the bread of heaven and call upon the same Lord. It's my strength and my salvation. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Eat and drink this in the remembrance of Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And in thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to be a witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.